Hello everyone, in this video lecture I am going to discuss controlled rectifier. Rectifier is an electronic circuit which is able to convert AC signal into a DC signal. In electronics, sometimes there is a requirement to convert AC signal into a DC signal, for which we use a circuit called rectifier. Earlier, means in linear electronics, rectifier is designed by diodes, but that is the uncontrolled rectifier. We have no control on the amount of output voltage. Here, at the place of diode, we are using SCR, silicon controlled rectifier. This is the symbol of SCR. It is denoted by T here. And since we are using only one SCR, so this circuit is called single phase half wave controlled rectifier. Single phase half wave controlled rectifier with pure resistive load. At the output side, there is a resistive type of load, and at the input side, we are applying a AC signal. Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. So now let us see what happens with the V naught and I naught, that is the output voltage and output current, when we apply a AC signal Vm sin omega t at the anode terminal of the SCR. As the load is pure resistive, so I naught is equal to V naught by R. Whatever we got the waveform of V naught, the same nature of waveform is for the I naught. Now let us see the waveform. The first waveform is a sine wave, that is the Vs supply voltage. Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. The second waveform is the gate pulse. As you know, when we apply the gate current, our SCR is going to be turned on. So when we apply the gate pulse or gate current, it can be decided by the designer. So this is the gate pulse, let us say at angle alpha, means the x axis is omega t. We have a 0 pi, 2 pi and 3 pi, 4 pi for the Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t input signal, and at the angle of alpha for every time period we are applying a gate signal. This alpha is called the delay angle or firing angle. Alpha is called as a delay angle or firing angle. Here after 2 pi we are applying the gate pulse at 2 pi plus alpha. So after the firing angle, our SCR is going to be turned on. Considering that this is the ideal SCR, there is no loss in the SCR, then we are getting this portion from alpha to pi at the output, means from alpha to pi V naught is equal to Vs. Similarly, after 2 pi plus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi, V naught is equal to Vs. By changing this alpha, we can change this area under the curve, means we can change the amount of output voltage. For the finding average voltage at the output side, we have to just integrate this output waveform, let us say the time period is 2 pi. So 1 upon 2 pi integration alpha 2 pi Vm sin omega t gives the average output voltage. When you integrate this, you will see that the alpha term is there in the output voltage. So by changing the alpha, you can change the output average voltage of this controlled rectifier. The next is I naught. I naught is V naught by R. So the waveform nature is same, only the amplitude is going to be decreased. If the amplitude of this V naught is Vm, the amplitude of this I naught is Vm by R, since it is a pure resistive load. And this is the VT, means voltage across the SCR. Voltage across the SCR is with this nature 0 to alpha, then alpha to pi is 0 because these all are coming at the V output, and then pi to 2 pi there is a negative voltage. So this type of waveform can be drawn for understanding the operation of single phase half wave control rectifier, since we are just doing the operation of half wave, only 0 to pi, not for pi to 2 pi. So it is called the half wave rectifier. Now let us see single phase full wave rectifier, full wave control rectifier. This is a circuit diagram for single phase full wave rectifier with pure resistive load. There is 4 SCR, 1, 2, 3, 4. SCR 1 and 2 is simultaneously on when 3 and 4 is off, and when 3 and 4 is simultaneously on, 1 and 2 is going to be off. So let us say 1 and 2 is going to be on by an angle alpha after in 0 to pi. This IG1 and IG2 is going to be at on after angle alpha, and IG3 and IG4 is going to be on in second cycle, means pi to 2 pi, and it is going to be on at an angle pi plus alpha. So T1 and T2 is on for alpha 2 pi plus alpha like that, and 3 and 4 is going to be on for pi plus alpha and 3 pi plus alpha like that. When 1 and 2 is on, our V output is equal to Vs. V output is equal to Vs. And when 3 and 4 is on, our V output is equal to minus Vs. So now let us see this waveform. The first waveform is the sine wave. The second is the gate current pulse for the IG1 and IG2. This is the gate pulse for IG3 and IG4. And we are getting in first cycle from alpha to pi, V naught is equal to Vs. And in second cycle, V naught is equal to minus of Vs. This is going to be positive side. So for finding the average value, you can see the time period of this waveform V naught is now 0 to pi. It is not 2 pi. 0 to pi, then pi to 2 pi, 2 pi to 3 pi. The same waveform is repeated. So we can integrate 1 upon pi integration alpha 2 pi Vm sin omega t d omega t. And similarly, you can find the I naught with the reduced amplitude, that is Vm by R. The nature is same. And remember that the alpha may be similar for IG1, IG2, IG3, IG4. Similar for IG1, IG2, but it is not necessary that similar for the IG3 and IG4. You can change. But for simplicity, generally we keep the alpha same for this 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we are getting the voltage across 1 and 2 and voltage across 3 and 4 when our SCR is when our V output is equal to 0. So when you find the average output voltage, again there is a term of alpha in V naught, and by changing that alpha we can control the average voltage of output. Hence it is called the control rectifier. As you increase the alpha, area under the curve is going to be decreased, so average voltage is going to be decreased. The maximum average voltage V naught can be calculated when alpha is equal to 0, and when alpha is equal to pi we get no output voltage for the control rectifier. Thank you.